I must say it's been a fantastic ride for me ever since I pitched the idea of the book to Penguin Random House. Radhika and her team said almost instantly, they said yes. And then I spoke to Mr. Jagannathan, who was both amused and skeptical. But he did say yes, and I'm very grateful to him and to all the people in his family, his colleagues, past and present, who gave me their time and their expertise, and which has gone into the making of this book. So I must say it's been a group effort through and through. Coming to a most important part, the two people who have been catalysts for this book, I must mention their names. They're my dear old friends, Melissa Arulappan and Bunty Pierboy. Please give them a hand, really. Moving on to our panel, Krishnakumar Natarajan, the founder of Mindtree. He's a global authority in IT and a co-founder of the company. The company itself is known for its innovative approach to providing IT solutions and services globally. KK, my first question will be to you.
Okay.
I thought you knew that already.
No.
Okay. So, you held several key positions in Wipro before you co-founded Mindtree. Tell me, what were the challenges that you faced when you moved on from being an employee to becoming an entrepreneur?
No, I know it's a very difficult transition, particularly if you're becoming an entrepreneur in your 40s. Probably it's easier when you're younger. The first thing which you realize is that in large companies, you associate the success of the company with yourself. What you realize as a startup is the amount of support, the brand of the company, and their own credibility in the market helps you. I think it's very interesting. We launched the company, I still remember, on 17th of August 1999. The same night I was off to US to go and seek customers. The same customers who, as a Wipro senior manager, would welcome me, they refused to sort of take calls. I wouldn't leave because I was so desperate for business, so I kept calling them. And one of my sort of most, I would say, desirable customers, I said, I'll walk into your office because I already landed in San Francisco. He said, no, let's meet at a coffee shop nearby. So the first thing you realize is that I think entrepreneurship grounds you and makes you practical. I think it sort of removes all the stigma that you are responsible for all the successes. And in a very lighter vein, it also hardens you because I think Wipro one was used to a business class travel as a startup. I had to do economy or cattle class, as Mr. Sashi Tharoor would call it. And maybe the next 10 years was 150 trips, which sort of hardened me as a person also.
My next question will be to Sandeep Maini, the chairman of the Maini Group, which is one of India's premier design and manufacturing companies. The group is in mobility, it's in aerospace, and it has pioneered electric vehicles in India. It manufactured the first commercially viable electric car, the Reva, which then, of course, it sold off to Mahindra's. I do know a lot about this part of their business because I co-authored a book on the Reva, Reva EV, India's green gift to the world, with Sandeep's father, Dr. Sudarshan Maini. Sandeep, did you always know that you would join the family business? And how did it impact your choices and decisions?
So Sandhya, before I respond, I have to tell you that I'm very privileged and humbled to be sitting here today. At the launch of a book of somebody who I've been a silent admirer for decades. So thank you for this opportunity. My answer is very short, yes. I always knew that I was going to join my father's business. And this was well before I even finished my 12th standard and went for engineering. I was very clear. My father, like all the stories here, was also a default entrepreneur and also at the age of 40. And therefore, I saw what he did. I saw what he and my mother built and how they did it. And the thing that struck me most was the value system that had to come in when you had to do something like this, and the support that was required to do this. And to me, that was very important. So yes, I always knew I was going to join the family.